honestly, man, sages, they've died giving their life because they...
But what about the victims? How do they get justice?
Yeah.
The victims.
The ones that killed.
Yes, the ones who killed. The babies who are killed. The children who are killed. How do they get justice?
I mean, if you think everything is just an illusion. And you go to heaven, is that your justice?
You're missing the point. Look, when someone dies, when someone is killed, that is not the end of it. Yes, that person who died might have a mother, might have a father, a brother, a sister, a family, children. Yes, they cannot just see, let this death be go unpunished without justice being served. This is human nature.
Yeah.
What you're saying is that just completely ignore all this.
No,
I'm not saying you personally, but people who say that this is all just an illusion and this is all just spiritual, one day you're going to die anyway. I mean, to me, they are basically completely divorced from the way of God, unfortunately.
I think.
But that is the philosophy. They say that when you reach enlightenment, you realize it's an illusion, so your fear goes away, your fear of death goes away.
What about the justice? I'm telling you.
You asked that. I guess you'd ask someone who's.
Well, you brought up the points. I'm assuming you know about it.
Well, that's what I've read.
But you need to question this. So when I read things, I analyze it.
Yeah, I question it.
I do question it. And then I come to the conclusion that yes, this is coherent.
Oh yeah, no. All right.
When
fine.
Somebody tells me that everything is an illusion, regardless of all the wars that happen, all the killing that goes on, all the good, all the bad. What's the point?
No.
It's just an illusion.
Just to clarify, I question it and I don't agree with it. I think you've got to defend yourself.
Okay.
I'm just saying that in Hinduism, there is that concept on fundamentally Maya, which is the world's an illusion. So when you die, you're not really dying because your soul is...
No, but the Hindus believe in reincarnation.
Yeah.
So it's not just the end for them.
Unless they're enlightened, in which case it breaks the cycle.
That's again a philosophy of Buddhism.
No, it's the same in Hinduism.
Oh yeah, because they have this reincarnation and
unless you reach enlightenment, then you break the cycle.
I think the Sikhs have it as well.
The who?
The Sikhs.
Yeah, I don't know.
They also believe in God as well. So do the Hindus.
All the others are just basically
I don't know enough about the Sikhs.
So I mean, I don't believe in this illusion thing. I don't believe in this reincarnation either.
Right.
I want to ask this question.
Well, you're a Muslim, so obviously, you know, it's different beliefs.
Yeah, but like I said, I question. Even in Islam, even in Hinduism, when I see something, I question it, I analyze it, and I question it. So if they tell me that, okay, my karma has basically, because I've been a good person, I've come back as a good person. Another person's karma might be bad because he's done a lot of bad things, all right? So maybe Hitler might come as a rat or something. Yes, because he's done a lot of bad things.
That's kind of what they would say.
Yeah. Yeah. So when you come as a vermin, yes?
A vermin, a rat.
Mm. What is the best thing a rat has to do in order to become a man again?
I've read different things about that.
You see, that is a question you need to ask.
Because I read that you go through the cycle of all the animals.
Because I really
want to...
Really,
no,
he means how do you increase from the rat to the next level?
I don't know.